Okay, I'm back for another video, but this one is I wouldn't normally do this on the channel because it's not really something I planned to do and a video I was planning on making. So here's the deal. So I have been volunteering at the park for several years, and this year, after several years, it's come to the point where I've been told where I need to start documenting the work that I'm doing at the park in some other capacity than what I've been doing in the past, which is working with the group that works here. So I've been told that I need to start documenting the work, and I'm going to start right now. So I really don't know how to do this because there's so much work to be done. So I'm just going to start at hole one and start walking and talking, and I don't really have any other plan. I you know, this is kind of spontaneously done. It wasn't really something I expected to do, so I'm just gonna walk through. And just in the last week, I've been here 25 hours easily working on the park and stuff that needed to be done. So first off, I want to say that I'm not the only person that works here. The city works here, and the Friends of Ferguson group works here also. And so I'm not the only one who does this work, but the whole purpose of this video is because I have been informed that I need to show my specific work here because it's not being documented properly up to this point. So here we go. All right, so hole one, just, you know, so this year, just looking at this tree right here, that ivy grows up on these holes every year, on these trees every year, on every tree in the woods, okay? So all of us do it, not the city, but all of us as volunteers have done this kind of work in the past. But this year, so this year specifically, I've done it twice already, where I've gone through several of the fairways and cut down the ivy, and I'm not even keeping up with it. So, you know, I normally do this kind of stuff, but obviously there's more that needs to be done. So, yeah, so we had a tournament here. Like, I always trim those little bushy things down with my weed trimmer whenever I make it by here, just keeping those somewhat in order. We clean up any of the dead branches up in here. I've done that several times. Every time I'm here walking the course, working the course, playing the course, I'm picking up all the sticks in the fairways and on the grass, making it easier for the city to do their job and protecting their mowers from getting damaged from large limbs and stuff like that. So right now, every fairway on the course is clean to the point where there are no sticks and limbs and stuff that will damage the lawnmowers. That's something I always pay attention to when I'm out here, and I'm out here weekly, once, twice, three times, sometimes five times a week. So to say exact time when I did everything is hard to do in the past because it's just been so many times in the past several years. It's been a continuous thing for 8 years. So this tree's not so bad, but that's the kind of stuff I do. So this year, you know, we had a work day. Kelly and Lou came out and mulched these trees, and we had a work day out here, but Kelly and Lou were doing a lot of different stuff than I was doing. That specific day, I came up here with my tractor and trailer and hauled around a bunch of wood that need to be stumps and stuff that need to be moved around. You know, we use those stumps as seats because we don't really have a budget for anything else. So we reuse the material, recycled material, the best we can. A lot of times the mulch that we get comes from the city that we give the wood to. So last night, I cleaned this up. It was overgrown, needed to be done. And the reason why I felt that this specifically needed to be done is because it's on the fairway. If you're throwing your disc on the fairway in disc golf, your disc should not get lost on the fairway. So discs were getting lost in here on and just hard to find. It just was needed to be done. So I did it. So that's one thing. You know, we pay attention to all these trees. That's not really my specific job. I don't do a lot of that, but I do get involved in those things. I trimmed all the way along this pathway because all this stuff is getting overgrown. Whenever I see poison ivy, I pick it because I'm the one person involved in this park that apparently doesn't get poison ivy, and I'm the only person that I know that picks poison ivy in this park. In fact, I can verify that. Nobody else does that. So trimming along this pathway, just making the pathways clear, just a little bit of trimming on these edges right here, but it needs to be done because all this stuff grows up and then hangs over into the walkway and rubs on you when you walk by. We're on hole two. So hole two, Lou and I came up here Memorial Day, and we cut hole two through six completely. All the fairways, all the trimming, everything that needed to be done on this, we did that on Memorial Day on hole two through hole six because it had not been done. And normally we expect that it is done, but it wasn't done and it needed to be cut pretty badly. It had been neglected, so we came up here and did two through six. Lou did most of this stuff on two, but I was here as well, did a little tiny bit. So between the two of us, you know, we hopped around. I did like, you know, I did a little bit of this work, went down in the woods and did just cut some of the bigger stuff there. This is the end of hole two. Trimmed the walkways up this fairway because this stuff gets overgrown too. And this is not too often, but about once a month this needs to be cut. So we're on hole three. All of this ivy here gets way overgrown. And just for example, like this little weed over here, this weed here is like 2 feet tall right now. So what happens is if this doesn't get done on a regular basis, what happens is everything starts growing up like that and it gets a stalk on it. And then we can no longer trim it and it requires a different kind of equipment and makes the job harder. So I come up here on a regular basis and make sure that all this stuff is down to a respectable level. And it's a fairway, so if you throw your disc in there, you should not lose your disc. So did this fairway, I did most of hole five. Lou was part of that also. Don't know exactly what he did, except for he was a big part of it also. He had the push mower and the trimmer out. I had the trimmer. I went through all this side stuff over here. All these trees have just big buildups of ivy and stuff around them, and I came around and trimmed those. Again, normally we pick all that ivy too, but we're behind on that. So just trimming everything here. I came in here, made sure all of the green area, by green I mean like a disc golf green, not like green grass. So the putting area around this basket, I've cleaned up this area because if you throw it here from the tee box, you should be rewarded with a decent putt. So within circle one, you should have somewhat decent area. So I do that on a regular basis. Cut up through here, trim this fairway again. So here's a good example here, this ivy here. This ivy right here likes to take over the whole park. The ground and the bushes. So anytime I see one of those in the last 8 years, I pick it. That's quite often, actually. It's at least the beginning of every year. I spend a couple hours trying to get that stuff out there. And just this past week, I spent about 30 minutes on Tuesday, last Tuesday night, doing that. So there's a good example right here where that stuff just overgrows everything and kills it and chokes it out and drowns out the sun. So can't do every single one of them, but that's what I do on a regular basis, and try to limit it to somewhat around the fairways and on the hole in general. So even though we have the fairway here, we have a rough that we don't do a whole lot with also. So another thing, so I come out here and I blow off these tee pads with my power blower on a regular basis to keep vegetation and just plant materials and stuff out of there, because that'll help prolong these tee pads and our use of them. They get clogged up with dirt and stuff in the AstroTurf, so I blow that stuff out of there. It's kind of dusty, but I do that on a regular basis. Make sure I blow all of the sidewalks, walkways. I blow the parking lot a couple times a month to clean it up. Every time I come up here, I clean up trash out of the parking lot. We're headed up two. So I did this week also. We're on hole two, on hole four now. And all this rough on the left side next to the creek. I came here and did all this stuff back here with my weed trimmer. And that's something I will do on a regular basis when it needs to be done. I don't have exact dates, days, how many times I've done it. Just say it's been like, I don't know, tens of times I've been up here in years doing this stuff. Cleaning up around the basket, make sure that's a decent putt. Make sure you have a decent chance there. Headed on to five. And I'm probably gonna make two videos here because this is going to take quite a while. Hole five. I put a couple of these tree stumps in about a month ago because someone at the park requested it, saying, hey, we need some more benches on hole five. So that's what I did. Easy peasy. Lou and I did this hole also. It's very nice and very clean. Lou did a lot of push mowing on this hole, and that was last Monday. I haven't done much since then, but I came through here with the weed eater also, and you know, just made sure these little things are cleaned up. They get overgrown. We don't mind them being obstacles, of course, but they just need to be trimmed down. There's another thing, I did a little bit around the trees, but obviously we're behind on getting all that ivy cleaned up, and just haven't had more time to do it. So those are things we have to do out here to make this work. Again, just make this green or this putting area clean enough that you make it down here, you're not losing your disc and you have a decent chance of putting. We have to keep things fair like that in the sport. Cleaned up this walkway. I always, whenever there's a tunnel or like a ceiling here, I always make sure these things are cleaned up on the way through. I'm not the only one who does this, but if there's anything ever hanging here along the way, make sure it's not protruding and causing problems for players. I didn't do much. I'm here just blow off the tee box on a regular basis. I did this with a weed trimmer with Lou twice this year already because everything has just grown quite a bit. So we're on hole six, walking up the fairway, and we normally do all of this hole as a group anyway because this isn't really very mowable. So we do this entire hole by weed eater. I think Lou might have had his push mower out a little bit, but I don't think we did it on this hole. I think Lou used the push mower up high on the top of the hole, but made my way all the way up here, clean up. There's a bunch of weeds growing along the edge of the bridge, all needs to be taken care of. Weeds around the trees, still behind on that. Some more ivy needs to be done. And I don't know who will end up doing that, but it's a possibility that I will because it's ivy. Normally blow these steps, but I've had more trimmer work to do, and I haven't really been doing a lot of the blower work that I usually follow it up with. I just haven't had the time. Here's another good example. This tree right here. We need to pull out this ivy, otherwise it's going to kill what we've got going on here. That needs to be done. I usually do that stuff too. You can see that the thing has just been overtaken by that ivy and it needs to be gone. So I normally do that stuff. This is nice and clean. We got a little pathway there that's usually used mostly for our tractor to get around here. This is a good time to bring up the tractor as we head to hole seven. So last Tuesday, I stayed after a round and I did some work here on the right side, walking up the walkway from the shelter. There's a big ivy covering up there that just covered this whole entire corner and just enveloped it, was choking it out and drowning it out. I pulled all that stuff out of there, pulled it up to the curb up there, and then the city took it from there. But it was just enveloping this whole corner and needed to be taken out, so I did. So the tractor, I come up here pretty often on my tractor because of hauling logs and brush and pulling stuff out of the woods. Here's a good example of things that we didn't do that we normally do and probably will at some point, but there's a pile of wood right there. I come up here on a regular basis and pick up piles of wood, haul them out to the curb for the city to take them, whether it's mulched or whatever they do, I don't know. Right now, it's okay, but pretty soon, this is gonna have to be trimmed up here on hole seven. It's fine, it's a little bit rough, but as soon as this stuff starts getting out of hand, we need to at least give it a once over every now and then. This one isn't so bad. You can see across the way where we're just probably not gonna recover that bush, but that whole thing is covered by ivy because we haven't been able to keep up with everything that needs to be done all the time and make it perfect. It's a growing forest, so we do what we can. Normally I'll pick the poison ivy out of here. I don't really see a whole